Good evening, students. Today I am here to teach you natural heritage of India. So, let's start. Natural heritage refers to the sum total of the elements of biodiversity, including flora and fauna, ecosystems and geological structures. Here, flora means vegetation and fauna means wildlife. So, it is a sum total of elements of biodiversity. Biodiversity means in one system we have human beings, we have flora, we have fauna, and all are living together and they all are interrelated to each other. So they make this ecosystem. Heritage is that which is inherited from past generations, maintained in the present and bestowed to future generations. Means heritage, the things, the resources which we get from our forefathers or from our past generations, we use in our present. We use, we conserve, we protect in present. Why we are protecting? Why we are conserving? So that our future generation can use that. So all the things which we get from our forefathers and using in the present and are saving for our future generation is known as natural heritage. There are many types of natural heritage such as landscape, rivers, vegetation, wildlife. So first we will discuss landscape. Here in this image we can see mountain and you can see the beauty of nature, the sunlight, how the grasses are showing in this image. So all the things are showing together in this one picture, that is landscape. The most important part of landscape is mountain. Beautiful landscapes are generally formed due to different shapes of land. For example, the Himalaya. So Himalaya is also one type of landform which is very important part of our landscape. In sceneries, in pictures, we can see the beautiful images of landscape as a mountain. It has endowed Indians abundantly with useful vegetation and minerals. So Himalaya is very important for vegetation purpose and minerals. Many minerals are extracted from Himalayas. Not only vegetables and minerals, strange birds, animals are also found in the Himalayas range. And these ranges are snow covered. So we can have many types of animals and birds in mountainous area. Brimming rivers are the gift of Himalaya. Means many rivers are coming from Himalayas. Most of the northern rivers are coming from Himalaya only. Next, forest of Tarai and its pilgrimage places, for example, Amarnath, Badrinath, Kedarnath, etc. are in Himalayas. So, most of the pilgrimages places are also found in Himalayas, that is the Tarai region. Tarai is the lowest range of the Himalaya, that is Shivalik range. Next we have rivers. Rivers have been providing natural ways since ancient time. And we know that our ancient civilization, that is Indus Valley civilization, was flourished near the bank of river. So the rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati, Indus, Narmada, Godavari, Krishna have profoundly influenced the people of India in many ways. Means these rivers are used by the people of India in many ways. Like it is the source of drinking water, domestic use, irrigation, electricity and waterways. We know that irrigation is very important for our agricultural activity. Electricity, to make the electricity, water is very important. So, river water is used to make the electricity. and of course and waterways, because in early time they were not having other sources of transportation. So people of India used waterways as a transportation. Next we have vegetation. We know that Indians love nature and Indians are the lover of nature. And we know that there is a interrelation between human, animal, bird, and all these things are dependent for food on trees. Means we all are getting our food from the vegetation. Not only food, but in religious way also we worship many trees like banyan tree, peepal tree and tulsi on different occasions. Besides these trees, we have other medicinal plants also which we use to cure many diseases like hade, amla, ardusi, neem, etc. Along with these medicinal plants, we have other beautiful plants which make our life very beautiful, that is rose, champa, damaro, sunflower, joy, etc. So we can say our life, Indian life, is greatly influenced by the vegetation. Next we have wildlife. Wildlife is also a great example of our cultural heritage. So India prides for a variety of animal life. It is a nature lover since ancient time. It is a country with animal lover culture. Tiger, lion, elephant, rhino, foxes, deer, saber, rabbit, python, snake, mongoose, like organisms are found and seen. So these many animals are found in India in different places due to its varied physiography and climate. Asian lions in the world are found only in the Gir forest of Gujarat, and this is only the one reason many foreigners come and visit to Gujarat for Gir forest to see the lions, Asian lions. Our religious belief has given a status of god goddesses vehicle to some of the animals, tiger, peacock, alligator, eagles, etc. So it is mentioned in many religious books that these many animals are the vehicle of god and goddesses. One example we have, rat is the vehicle of Ganpati, Lord Ganesha.